Hello, good afternoon, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capellan Jr. Always wish you a good day. Now today what I'm going to do is to walk you through with a functional block program that can be uploaded into a DDC to control the control panel, which is in auto position. Okay, now in my previous tutorial I already explained the motor control wiring diagram in auto position. Okay, then I show you also how it will be connected to a DDC controller. Now this is my DDC controller. If you have not seen that video, please do watch and learn the simple connection of a DDC or a controller, how it will control a simple motor control. Okay, now from that tutorial we have learned that we need to provide some information to our direct digital controller or our controller or a PLC, some information that our program will use to be able to decide if it will start the control panel. Now what I have here is my functional block programming. Okay, so this is FB. Okay, functional block. Okay, now in a simple data or information processing, we have the input process then output. So we need some inputs, okay, then we need to do some processing, okay, then based on that processing it will produce the necessary output. Okay, now in this simple functional block program, I have here the inputs at this side. Okay, I have a DI block. Okay, so this DI block, we need to provide an identifier. Okay, now identifier in the programmer's point of view, that is just like a variable. Okay, so I have here 1, 2, 3 DI blocks. Okay, so DI blocks are digital input blocks. Okay, so as you see, there is some information here that this one is coming from a normally open contact. Okay, so just like this run status, it's also coming from a normally open contact. Then trip status will be coming also from a normally open contact. Now these contacts are the one we are providing in our control panel. Okay, so we have to provide BMS points. So we call this BMS points, these three relays here, and it will be received by our digital DI blocks or BI blocks. Okay, now this DI block, we need to map it. We are calling map in building management system. When you say map, you need to map these points to the channel of your DDC. Let's say this DI1 will be mapped to our first binary input here. Then that binary input one will be coming from, or the cable will go to the relay in your control panel. Then this DI run status will be mapped to our controller channel 2, BI2. Okay, as I explained in my previous tutorial. Then this third block is DI, which is trip status. Then again, it will be mapped to our controllers binary input number 3. So meaning when I say map, where this DI block will take the information. So it will take the information from the controller BI1, then this BI1 is will get the information from the control panel, and that control panel is providing the handoff auto status. Okay, so this is the DI blocks. Okay, that is the DI blocks. It will receive a normally open contact or a normally closed contact, and it is a bolt free contact, BFC. So we can give just a contact here, an open or closed contact. When it is closed, meaning this one will become 1. Okay, so the output, this is the input side and this is the output side. If this contact closes, then that will be 1, then the output will be 1. Okay, okay, so then this will become an input to your and logic gates. Okay, so I have here in my process side is the AND gate. Okay, so meaning in my functional block programming, I will be using different blocks. So in this program, I just use di and not gate and gate and not gate, then one do block. Okay, so let me explain this process side. Okay, now I receive or I define already my three digital inputs. Okay, now first, in order to start the control panel, I need two information. Okay, first, I need to know if the panel is in auto position or the selector switch is already in auto. So by in our control panel, we have a relay that will give us the information of this. So when someone put the panel or the selector switch in auto, now this contact will close, then this one will become one. So I have an input one in my AND gate. Okay, so I have one here. Now guys, those beginner, the AND gate, there is a truth table. We call truth table in AND gate. So meaning both input should be one before this gate will give an output of one. So remember that one. So both inputs, I have an input A here. Let's say this is A, this is B, and this is C. Now both inputs should be one. So I should be having one here, I should be having one here before this one will give a one output. Okay, so meaning this truth table or this AND gate will give a one output. If I have one here, then this will become one. Okay, now this is input letter A, okay, A, B. Now this one I am using here a NOT gate. So NOT gate, as shown by this symbol, a triangle and a dot in front of it. Okay, meaning this signal, if this is one, it will be inverted to zero. If this is zero, it will be inverted to one. Okay, now the condition that I will start my my motor is it is in auto and there's no problem with the motor. Of course, it's very obvious you cannot start a motor when it is in a trip condition. Okay, so obviously it should not be in a trip condition before you can start it. So how it works like this, it should be in auto and there's no trip. So this is zero, because if it's trip, it is one. So it should not, there should be no trip. So it should be zero. Then this is zero, then it will be fed to our NOT gate, then it will be inverted to one. So it will become one here. So zero, one. Okay, so I have one and one here, then the output will be one. Then that one will go to the DO blocks. Okay, so the DO blocks, as you can see here, I have also here, this DO block, it has a built-in relay, or my controller has a built-in relay. Then this relay will be the one to activate this contact. Now this contact is the one that will go to our control panel. As you remember, we have there BMS start stop. So this contact will go to that normally open contact. Then when it's one, then this contact will close. Then our 24 volts will come from here. Then it will go back to the control panel. Then it will start our magnetic contactor as shown in my auto position control wiring diagram. Okay. So this is a very simple programming. Okay, so let's trace the signal. So someone put it in auto, so this one will become one. Okay, so I have an input of one here. Okay, now here it says there should be no trip before I can start the motor. So there should be no trip, so this one is zero. Okay, so it will go to our input to our NOT gate, so this one will become one. As I said, if you have an input of zero here, it will be inverted to one. If you have one, it will be inverted to zero. So zero, it will become one. So I have an input here, one. Okay, then in our truth table of an AND gate, both input should be one before it will give an output of one. Okay, so this is one, then this one will become one. So this one will become one. Okay, so meaning the contact will close, then it will go to the control panel, then the control panel, the provision there for BMS start stop, it will close, then the motor will start. Okay, now let's retrace. How about if it trips? Okay, so if it trips, okay, let me erase it. So assuming it is running, then it trips, so this one will become one. Okay, because it trips, this one closes. Then this one will become zero, then this one will become zero, then the output will be 0 because of the truth table. Both input should be 1 before it will get 1 output. Okay, so this one will become 0. So that is 0, then this one will be 0. Okay, so obviously our BMS will release the command to the control panel, so the motor will stop. Okay, as you can see guys, control logic programming, this type of functional block is very easy for beginners. Okay, now of course when you are going to write the control logic program, you need to know what is the approved sequence of operation of the system that you are going to control. Okay, as you can see, this is very simple, but if you have a complicated sequence of operation, let's say there is a fire alarm or there are some protection, let's say operator enable, time schedule is when this equipment should start, time schedule is when, let's say, it should start at this time of the day, so you can include it in your functional block. So there are so many blocks that you can get from the engineering tool. This is called engineering tool programming. Okay, so there are built-in blocks that all you need to do is use it in your control logic program. So guys, this is the very basic program how to start this simple motor control. Okay, so I guess now you have a clear picture from manual control, from power diagram, then manual control wiring diagram, then automatic control wiring diagram, then how we are going to interface our panel to a DDC, then how are we going to write a simple program, upload it in our controller, then let that controller control the equipment. Okay, so guys, in my YouTube channel I have prepared 9 tutorials for this simple motor control, 9 video tutorials. Okay, it will start from power diagram, then explaining all the basic components, okay, of the power diagram, starting from main circuit breaker, magnetic contactor, overload relay, isolator switch, okay, down to the motor. Then in that tutorial I'd explain its purpose of these components of the power diagram. Then comes the manual wiring diagram for the control, which starts with the control transformer going to our control components like selector switch, start stop, push buttons, then indication lamp. Okay, then our auto control wiring diagram using the same components in our manual control, okay, but adding some relays to be able to feed some information to our DDC. Then DDC, how it you are going to connect this panel. So let's say if you are the BMS engineer, you need to ask the panel fabricator, okay, I need these BMS points. So these points will be provided to you through relays and some contacts, normally open and close contact. Then you are going to pull cable, bring it to your DDC, then upload the program, prepare a control program like this for a simple one, then upload it in your controller, then let the controller control your equipment. Okay, so guys, this is a simple one, but it's complete, it's for beginners, okay, new engineers, newly graduate student of engineering courses, or any technical guy who are wishing to join building management system. Actually, this is for building automation or building management system. Okay, guys, I do hope I have given you a complete, simple tutorial on how you are going to connect a simple motor in your control panel, how are you going to do the power diagram and control wiring diagram and connection to the DDC and simple programming. Okay, it's already complete for you guys. All you need to do is watch. And if you are new to my channel, needless to say, please subscribe, like, share the video, and you can always put a comment, and you can also click the notification bell so you will be notified for my next video tutorial for this same topic. Okay, so again, thank you for watching, and I'm always say, let's all be safe, and God will bless us all, and bye for now.